Right then, so for today's video, we're going to be taking a look at finding the area of a sector. In our last video, we actually looked at finding the arc length of a sector, and we're going to use a similar kind of method that we did for those questions for these ones today. If you want to check that video out, I'll leave a link for it in the description and a card in the top corner. So for our first question, we've got to find the area of the sector, given our answer in terms of pi. So for this first question, we can see we've got a semicircle. So all we have to do in these cases is find the area of the whole circle, and then because we've got half a circle, all we have to do is then half it. So to find the area of this semicircle, we'd use the formula for the whole circle, which is simply pi r squared, but then we'd have to half it, so we'd just divide by 2. So now what we're going to do is substitute. For the area, though, we need the radius. In our question, we've got that the diameter is equal to 20. So if the diameter is 20, the radius would just be half of that, which is 10. So substituting into pi r squared, we've got pi times r squared. Well, we know that the radius is 10, so we're multiplying by 10 squared, which then we have to divide by 2. So we've got pi times 10 squared, well, we know 10 squared is 100, so pi multiplied by 100 is the same as 100 pi, which then when we divide by 2 would simply just be 50 pi. So our final answer to this question would be 50 pi. Then using the correct units, because we were working with centimetres, our area would therefore be in centimetres squared. Okay, we're going to do a very similar thing for this question. We've got to find the area of the sector again, giving our answer to 2 decimal places this time. Well, if we look, we've actually got a right angle. We know we've got 90 degrees of this entire circle. Well, we know in an entire circle there's 360 degrees, so fractionally we've got a quarter. So to find the area of this sector, I'm just going to use the area for the entire circle, which would be pi r squared. But because I've only got a quarter, I would then divide this result by 4. So now what we're going to do is substitute in. So we've got pi multiplied by the radius squared. Well, we've got the radius is 9, so it's going to be pi times 9 squared, which then we divide by 4. So we know that 9 squared is 81, so this would be the same as 81 pi divided by 4. So all we have to do is pop that into the calculator because we want it to decimal places. So if we do 81 pi divided by 4, we actually get 63.6172 and a few extra. That's enough to round. So to 2 decimal places, this would be 63.62. So our final answer would be 63.62. And because we were dealing with centimetres, our units would be centimetres squared for the area. So for our next question, we're finding the area of the sector again, but this time we've got a radius of 15 centimetres and an angle of 32 degrees. So this time we haven't got a simple fraction of the circle. So what we're going to do now is we're going to find the fraction of the circle that we're actually dealing with. So we've got 32 degrees in this sector out of a possible 360 degrees of the entire circle. So this sector as a fraction of the entire circle would simply be 32 over 360. So that's the fraction of the entire circle that this sector represents. So all I have to do to find the area of this sector is take that fraction and multiply it by the general formula for the area of the entire circle, which we know is pi r squared. So substituting in, all we'd have is 32 over 360 multiplied by pi, and then our radius is 15, so we'd be multiplying that by 15 squared. So we can do that all in one go on the calculator. If we do 32 over 360 multiplied by pi, then times 15 squared, we get 62.8318 and a few extra. So then to round this to 2 decimal places, this would be 62.8 and the 3 would remain as a 3. So our final answer would be 62.83. And then because our length was in centimetres, our area would therefore be centimetres squared. And we can use that method we've just learned to find the area of any sector. So for this question here, we've got to find the area of this sector, giving our answer to 2 decimal places again. So we've got a radius of 5 centimetres, an angle of 135 degrees. So we know fractionally of the entire circle, this sector would be 135 over 360 multiplied by the area for the entire circle, which we'd find by using pi r squared. So this question here would be 135 over 360 multiplied by pi. Substituting in for r, we know the radius is 5, so I'm going to put 5 squared. So typing that in as we see it into the calculator, 135 over 360 multiplied by pi times 5 squared would give us 29.4524 and a few extra, which to two decimal places would simply be 29.45. So our final answer is 29.45. If our length is in centimetres, again our area is in centimetres squared. And for our final question today, we've got to find the area of this sector here, given our answer to two decimal places. We've got a radius of 12 centimetres and an angle of 310 degrees. So again, just like the other questions, the fraction that this sector represents of the entire circle would be the angle, which is 310 over 360. We then multiply that by the formula for the area of our circle, which would be pi r squared. So substituting in, we've got 310 over 360 multiplied by pi, and then we're going to substitute in the radius. So I'm going to open bracket. Our radius is 12, which then we square, close bracket. So then typing that into the calculator as we see it, we get 389.5574 and a few extra, but then to two decimal places we'd simply have 389.5 and then the 5 would round up to a 6. So our final answer to this last question is 389.56, because our length is in centimetres, again our area it would be in centimetres squared. So well done if you followed along with those, and that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are at all any topics you'd like me to go over next, then please do just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.